This video shows you how to align the wing and table for your professional cabinet saw. Typically, you should be able to align a cast iron wing with the main table using the normal installation procedure. However, due to the flexible nature of cast iron and other circumstances, the leveling and alignment between the main table and extension wings could be slightly off and require particular adjustment. The seam between the table and a wing may be uneven. The outer edge of a wing could be lower or higher than the outer edge of the table. An uneven seam can be corrected by slightly flexing the wing per the location of the mismatch. A wing outer edge that's too high or too low can be corrected by shimming. First, turn off the power switch. Unplug power. Remove the lockout key. Lower the blade completely below the table. Remove the table insert. Begin by confirming the flatness of the main table. Place a straight edge on the main table from one corner to the diagonally opposite corner. Make sure the straight edge rests only on the main table, not the wings. Make sure there is no more than a 1/10,000 inch gap anywhere along the straight edge. Repeat to check the flatness between the other opposing corners. If the flatness for the table is out of spec, contact SawStop Service. Now set the alignment of the seam between the table and a wing. You align and tighten the wing in a progressive manner. First, loosen the cap screws that attach the wing to the table. Loosen the bolts that attach the wing to the rails. Begin the alignment with one of the inner cap screws. Align the seam at that cap screw and then fully tighten. Repeat for the other inner cap screw. Once the inner seam is aligned and tightened, align either the front edge or rear edge and then tighten that corresponding cap screw. In this example, with three of the four edge zones aligned and tightened, the front edge is now slightly out of alignment. Because cast iron is flexible, you can correct this problem by slightly flexing the wing. Because the front edge is out of alignment, the switch box must be removed to make space. Place a block of wood on the wing and table, overlapping the seam, and then use a clamp to push the edge of the wing into alignment. The other kind of alignment issue is when the outer edge of a wing is either lower or higher than the parallel edge of the main table, even when all the cap screws are fully tightened. The first method is to take advantage of the strength of the rails to hold the wing in alignment. First, make sure the cap screws that attach the wing to the table are tight. Loosen the bolts that attach the wing to both rails. Then lift up or push down, as needed, to make the wing level with the table. You may need assistance to simultaneously hold the wing and tighten the bolts. The second method is to use tape to shim the edge. This example uses packing tape, cut to a 26-inch by half-inch strip. Begin by noting whether the outer edge of the wing is too low or too high. Next, remove the wing. To do so, remove the four cap screws, and then remove the bolts that attach the wing to the rails. Take care to prevent the wing from falling. In this example, the outer edge of the wing is too low, so you would shim the lower portion of the surface that contacts the table to force the wing up. If the outer edge of the wing is high, shim the upper portion to force the wing down. Reinstall the wing. It's a good idea to insert screwdrivers or something similar through the holes in the rails on the wing to prevent the wing from falling while you attach the wing to the table. You have learned how to align the wing and table for your professional cabinet saw. Thanks for watching. If you have questions, contact SawStop Service.